We basically just kept saying dig a hole in slightly different
ways that got way more offensive.
Yes.
One meant go dig a hole in your mother, which is just, yeah.
Okay, I got a 3 to punch him in the face.
I'm going to try and punch him directly under his beard. Like in the soft, fleshy bit that the beard doesn't protect.
In his dwarf craw.
I got a 2 if I use my momentum, which I do, to sail past your fist.
Alright, so right now we're swinging and missing.
Rope-a-dope. Rope-a-dope. Okay, I don't know what I was trying to roll.
Okay.
I was trying to get him discombobulated with fists.
Pretty sure then you're rolling a 5.
Okay, good, good.
Okay, so that's 0.
I want to create the discombobulated situation aspect, and that gives me 2 free invokes. Good.
Okay. Oh shit, 2 free invokes.
Yeah,
oh.
I succeeded with style because you didn't spend anything or defend yourself.
Oh, I see. First, I'm just going to roll fight to see what happens. And once again, try and punch you right in your bearded face. And I'm going to get different dice, because fuck these dice.
You punched my beard, probably tear out a few strands, it hurts.
It's probably an insult.
Is that it? Enough? That?
I mean, yeah.
Punching someone directly in the beard is probably an insult.
Now I'm going to try to hit you as hard as I can in the face.
Fair enough.
Do you have the knuckle dusters on?
Yes, I do.
Oh, wait, you actually drew a weapon?
I'm always wearing those things if I'm punching people.
Oh, okay. You see, I was avoiding magic in my sensor and all that because... But okay.
They're knuckle dusters. They're for fisticuffs. I had them on when I was doing this.
So he's trying to discombobulate Danzel.
Indeed. All right.
Wait, is he trying to discombobulate me or just make smoke in the room?
Oh.
Okay, so it's your turn.
All right.
He has basically... done the ninja smoke bomb thing. It's about that thick.
He's still discombobulated, right?
Oh, yeah.
A little bit, yeah.
You still got that impact.
Okay. Whirl and burn.
What?
Let's see. Going to use some of my money, because he's already brought magic into it. And, I'm going to turn that smoke into whirling embers. Burning bits of copper. And just whirl it around him and try to... basically just cause as much confusion and pain as possible without doing anything lethal. 4 that he needs to defend against with, I don't know what it's your call.
Lore. You're using magic against me.
You can't see me using magic against you.
That doesn't mean I don't know what's magic.
You know, I have no idea how you're going to defend, but it's Zach's call.
And it's my
He
invoke.
Can probably defend.
I mean,
sure he can use his invokes.
Like burning hands, so I'm gonna have to say you're gonna have to defend against this with athletics.
Oh, really?
It's not as straightforward as me fire blasting you. It's all around you and swirling and stuff.
That is my smoke.
Yep.
I mean, even if you're enhancing it and trying to do stuff with it, that's mine.
I am currently in control of it, but it's yours. You've still got the invoke.
So, what I would like to do is take back control of it, heat it up, and swirl it around him harder.
Okay.
Is what I want to try and do.
You want to make a lore attack?
Yeah. Pretty much, yeah.
So am I defending with athletics, or since I just directed that smoke, am I defending with lore? Which one?
I'd say lore.
Well, it's burning hands, is what Zach just
said. Yeah, but you guys are fighting for control over it now. That's why I think lore.
Well,
but obviously it's Zach's call. I don't even know this game.
I was going to make an attack with it.
Well, my lore is burglary at this moment.
Yeah, at this moment... where you're both fighting over this resource with your magic, I'm going to say you're going to have to probably defend with your lore.
Cool. Well, currently I'm using my burglary for my magic, so...
7.
Alright then. I got a 5, so I'll just check my number 2 stress box. Rawr! Probably hand burns, I guess.
However, because... you're using the smoke as the attack, right?
Yep, smoke and embers, yeah.
Okay. I'm going to say that smoke is mostly dissipated now, because not only did you use the invoke on it, both of you have been using it as a medium for your attacks.
Fair enough.
Yeah, there's still a haze in the area, but the smoke has mostly cleared.
I like how we're still both trying to keep this non-lethal, though. It's a civil bout of shut the fuck up. Don't you talk about my mother.
Just want to inflict crippling, horrible pain.
You're just casting crippling, horrible pain?
On his intestines.
Trying to make me violently shit myself into defeat?
More or less.
I'm gonna give you IBS, boy.
And his intestines already aren't doing so well today.
His intestines are fine. It's the liver that's missing.
It's a 4.
Okay. Lord?
This is probably not actually an attack. This is probably me trying to create an aspect.
What would you suggest that I defend with?
Not physique, maybe? He's probably got a high physique. He's got a good chance.
I'm gonna... No. 2 in physique.
Well, either way.
Yes, 4.
Yeah.
Y'all need to hurry up. Because I'm planning to wait till you guys get to down to, like, 2 stress and then jump in and beat the shit out of both of you, and this is taking way too damn long.
I'm gonna actually start coming after you with my sensor and swinging it like a flail, like I probably usually do. I'm not hitting your head or anything, like, although it is the sensor of broken thoughts. No, this is a civil fight. I'm just going to hit you in the gut. Mostly because of what you did to mine, and I'm fighting to not shit myself right now. Does he have to have a consequence, or can that go away after this?
I mean, if not, I will pull my... insistent on taking it, so...
I was going to say,
I can stay in the fight if I don't take it. I have to go down.
Oh.
I'm jumping in.
Yeah. Because I just doubled over Beardy, buddy.
You just knocked the shit out of Beardy, buddy, and while I think you're spitting the cork in the fire was pretty badass, this has gone a little too far.
Yeah.
So... I'm just gonna jump in. That's a 6.
Oh, against me?
Yeah.
Okay. I will roll to defeat. Well, actually.
No, that's a 7. My bad.
I will probably actually need to roll to defend. Otherwise, I'm going to be in the same shape as Beardy, buddy.
Well, I mean, you can always just concede and say that she's like a pommel knocks you across.
Yeah, I'm just running over there with the pommel and just being like, that's enough!
So, you have 2 laid out dwarves on the ground, groaning.
Not quite laid out, I'm more or less doubled over.
Oh.
You're laid out.
Yeah, I'm little laid out.
Little bit of crystal vomit there.
I'll drag you guys out of the street into some alley, and then I will leave you there, I will go back into the dragon's hoard, I will get some more booze, and then I will come back and sit there.
I thought you were outside the Musky Dolphin. Why would you go to the Dragon's Hoard?
Because they have better booze.
Oh, fair enough. I wake up in an alley next to you, and you have
drinking.
Yeah. So that was fun. Did you bring my bottle of wine down? I wasn't done with it.
Yeah. Here it is. She hands you the bottle.
The empty one.
Yes.
Yay. Fling. Crash. Ow!
We had let that get a bit out of hand, hadn't we?
So, sorry about that. I got a little worked up.
As
I had a stressful day.
Things happen.
Yes.
Indeed.
Shake.
Shake.
Shake. Actually, shake. There we go.
I want to hit him with a recovery there.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. Magic healing touch. 5. Fuck it, I'll try again. Ain't nothing stopping me.
Yeah. Fuck the police.
Like, no, I will work on you until I get that shit. No. Yeah, 5.
It takes longer than you expected to, which makes you just feel worse about it, but you eventually manage to make it recover.
Alright. Oh, I am a little out of practice with that.
The amount of invokes that he had at the beginning, if he actually wanted to lay your ass
out
for all eternity, he could have.
I'm sure.
Let's see.